It's Katie, and if you're wondering why the background is really different and why I'm wearing this and it's different from the thumbnail right now, it's because I am refilming this intro. Today, I am doing that part two, sharing more of my subject-specific tips for how you can get a 7 on that exam. You guys may have already seen my last video, my how I got straight 7s for chemistry, math, and English. And you might be wondering where the other three subjects went, because I also did economics, computer science, and Chinese. If you are new to my channel, welcome to the Alohana. Aloha, you should subscribe down below to join our family. I upload 2 videos every week, so don't miss out. Also, while you're down there, you should click the bell to turn my notifications on. And if you do both, I get free shoutouts like these wonderful people on screen, spreading the Alohana love. And comment Aloha, don't be a silent viewer, because I love reading your comments. If you have any questions, just comment them down below or message me. My socials are all at AlohaKittyX. But without further ado, here are my remaining tips for you guys. I will be in a different shirt, but don't mind that. Woo! For econ, there were three sections. Paper one was 2 essays with 2 parts each on microeconomics and macroeconomics. Paper two was a data response on international trade and development. Then paper three was quant, so calculations on the mathematical side of econ. I used the textbook a lot for econ. I used Tchaikovsky's and for a lot of the practice questions and also the explanation for econ. It makes so much sense. I'm a textbook person. I believe that's the Cambridge one, but there's also an Oxford one. Memorize key terms for econ. Our teacher made us do it. We had to memorize like 20 something pages of vocab terms because they are really helpful. You use them when you're introducing your essays in paper one. Paper two, they ask you about definitions. In paper three, they ask you to define some things. I also memorized graphs. There were so many graphs we had to memorize, but for each graph, you also need to have an explanation. And don't forget your titles, your units, your labels, everything. All that is really important. Now, this tip applies to everything. During your reading time, decide your prompt. When your reading time is over, you will need to start your essay and not waste any more time. Start thinking about how you're going to organize the essay, what points you're going to do, what examples you're going to use, and start writing those ideas down so you don't forget them and can write them properly in your essay after. If you're stuck between two prompts and you're thinking part A for this is harder, but part B is easier, and the other one is the opposite case, let me tell you that part B is worth 15 points and part A is worth 10 points. So probably you will go with prioritizing which one has an easier part B. Know which one you can score more points on and use that prompt. Sometimes you will have to make sacrifices, opportunity costs. For part B of paper one, you know there are so many points and evaluations you have to make. So I would suggest for every prompt, you can categorize micro topics and macro topics into bigger umbrellas that they almost always ask. Our teacher gave us a lot of evaluation phrases. Some ways you can do this is by prioritization, comparing short run versus long run, comparing different stakeholders, so you can holistically analyze a policy and evaluate it from all perspectives. Use real life examples and quantitative data in part B to support your arguments. Our teacher made us add at least 6 examples every essay, and it was very helpful. Make sure you use real life examples. I think they can be within the past 10 years, but obviously the more recent, the better. Add variety in doing other taxes on different products and in different parts of the world. Also, for paper one, use a transition phrase from your part A to a part B paper so that it all flows smoothly. Examiner appreciates it, and it shows that you know how these two topics connect. And in IB, in the essay, it's all about showing the examiner that you know what you're talking about. For paper two, don't ever start questions with a graph. If you really start with a definition of a key term, so if it's asking about monopolistic competition, define monopolistic competition, then graph it, and then explain the graph. For paper three, use 2 decimal places. That is so important. And don't forget your positive and negative signs for PED. PES. Now for computer science, honestly, the best tip I can give you is go to my teacher's website. He has made slides for every unit, including option D, Java, or object-oriented programming, which is what I did as well. So I'll link it down below. Just, you can use those. They're on the sidebar on the right. You'll see presentation tabs like topic one, system fundamentals, and they go down. You can use those. Though there is a fee, I think though, if you are interested, if you're in an IB computer science class, I would suggest you ask your teacher to pay for it. And then if he does on behalf of the school, then all the students will get access for it. So just, there are instructions on his website. And also, if you're stumped on your IA or don't know something, Google it. Stack Overflow is your best friend. Now finally, for Chinese, I did Chinese B, SL. Recap, first paper was reading comprehension. They gave 4 articles and you had to answer 30 to 40 questions. And then paper 2 was you had to write an essay based on a prompt and respond to it. For paper 1, reading comprehension is normally one of the most difficult things for me and my classmates, but I managed to pull through. I'm pretty sure I just scraped that 7 for reading comprehension specifically. But just remember, same goes for all languages. If you don't understand a certain character or you don't understand a phrase, it's not that of the world. Just like you would read something in English, there are going to be some words you naturally don't know, but you just have to look at the context and the surrounding piece as a whole, and you can get a general idea of what the text is about. And with that, you can score points, you can answer the questions. So it is all about using context clues, just understanding the general gist to produce the answers. There have been so many times where I didn't really know what the question was about or what the article was about, and just by looking at the image, inferring a lot from it, looking at the keywords and phrases that I was able to recognize, I could answer questions. Then for paper 2, as you know, there are 5 prompts. There's technology, culture, tradition, health, things like that. And you don't know the prompt specifically, but you know that it will be related to that topic. So I would suggest preparing a mind map or a list of keywords, sentence structures, linking conjunctions, idioms, structures, or the text type. And you can choose what you want to talk about technology, but know those keywords so you can use them. And also, idioms are always a good thing. I always use like 各种各样, 越来越, whatever. Because these idioms, if you put 2 or 3 of them in your piece, they really take that piece to another level and show that you know you're Chinese, because you're saying deep metaphorical words. But you know, to keep in perspective, if reading comprehension is a struggle, to keep in mind though that your Chinese grade is also determined by a lot of other things. For the oral part, I would practice a lot with your teacher, practice with Chinese speaking friends, Google Translate phrases that you want to say or you typically say, and make sure you get the tone right. Just play Google Translate here, listen to the Chinese person or whatever language you take, and try to imitate the tones exactly, because you know in Chinese specifically there are different tones, and one way of saying like si versus si is, it means 2 different things, 4 and death. So you know, you have to make sure you say it right. As usual, work with your teacher. They have a lot of knowledge on the language they're teaching and can add wisdom and more complicated phrases to your piece. Then just briefly gonna talk about the IAs for econ. Just make sure that all your IAs are on different topics or different units. Make sure your articles are from different publishers, different continents or places around the world, and that you use different graphs and key terms. For chemistry, you really need to pay attention to your equipment, your precision, and all that nitty-gritty stuff, because in sciences, you know that stuff matters. For computer science, start early or just work really hard. It's gonna be a long project, but it's also gonna be super rewarding. So for math, make sure your equations are actually from the equation editor, because you can do x1, but really you mean x subscript 1. So make sure that you are using it right and not just dumping it in one. If it's a fraction, don't just do a slash, actually put the numerator and denominator. For TOK, use TOK terminology, real world examples, and evaluate things similar to econ from different perspectives, different ways of knowing, talk about how different areas of knowledge, suggest different things, you know, to show you have the holistic viewpoint, which is a lot of what TOK is about, because I stuck to human sciences and natural sciences, and ways of knowing of reason, emotion, and I think perception. EE, just please start early. I had to finish it my summer between junior year and senior year. Not the most fun thing, but it's senior year is gonna get, well, it depends on your school, of course, but in my school, senior year was really rough, because you do TOK, you do college apps, whatever you can, start early so you can get it out of the way sooner. I hope you guys found those tips helpful. It is current me again. Give this video a thumbs up if you found it helpful. If you want to see more IB tips videos, comment down any requests you have. I'd be happy to do them. Anything that helps you. Subscribe to my channel here and my vlog channel here. You can click the top right eye to watch more of my videos. Scan my Snapchat on your right and follow me on social media at AlohaKittyX. Thank you for watching. Best of luck with IB. I believe in you. You can do this. I am supporting you. And I love you so much. Thank you for watching. Bye, guys.